Welcome to Charlottesville. Just 1 month remaining in the softball regular season, and this is a pivotal non-conference clash between Liberty out of Conference USA and Virginia out of the ACC. Ground ball over to first. It's booted by the first baseman, Eaton. And there is one batter for Liberty, one error for the Virginia defense.
One, lots of doubles, triples, home run power.
This one's into center field, right into the glove of Kelly Ayer for out number one. Ball and two strikes here on Wilson. Reaches out for it. Hokes plays to first, and she makes it in time, two away.
Looking for more RBIs from her team.
2-2 sent skyward. Center field for Ayer. She gloves it for the final out. So the leadoff hitter.
Fiery player, likes her in that two spot. That energy on offense as well.
Chopper over to short. Barrett can't make the play. So Jade Hilton.
Combination also mixes speeds well, and that creates a lot of ground ball outs.
Boggs right back to the pitcher, gets the lead out at second, and that is it as Hilton is erased. A lot of pressure on their pitching staff as the 1-1 comes in, and that one is flipped into center field and handled by Wilson for out number two.
Country and stolen bases, you know they're going to be in motion quite a bit in this game.
They'll get the shore out at second base. Byram to Barrett. Erasing the lead.
She just has this infectious energy about her. You can't help but be excited listening to her and, you know, excited about her team this season as well. But also feeling fresh.
Punched out to center field for Ayer. She reels it in, two away now here in the second. KK Madry. And started her career at LSU, bounce it back to Hogue, and she retires Madry. A 1-2-3 frame here in the second. Bigham through the final 5 2/3, striking out 9, as that's back up the middle, and there is a base hit for Virginia to start off the second. Leadoff is on as Kuhn rips the single.
Hawks, but they're just looking to string some hits together.
This is towards third. What a catch! Crane holds it in. Not in time to get Kuhn advancing to second. You're saying, how do you get back offensively? That is certainly one way. As Kelsey Hackett offers at the 0-1. It's on the infield, though. This is not going to get it done in any way. And Byram makes the play.
Going into this game.
Got her on the rise ball, and MC Eaton down on strikes.
The ace, but they all complement each other.
Sent skyward to shallow left center, and Ayer make the call on the catch.
Harden tries to do is give them two on Friday and maybe three on Saturday and two on Sunday, really spread them out. It's worked really
opposite
well.
Opposite way for Cabrell.
Of a series, you're going to really ride your ace, and if they're on, you're just going to allow her to try and finish that game. But not with Virginia. They have very making good decisions about pitching changes.
Kelly Ayer has been busy. That's already the ability to deliver complete sentences when you've got four gloves stacked on your head and shin guards being placed on you. Barrett's going to reel that in for
wild early in the season, has really toned that down, limited the free passes. Coming into her own.
That's out to left and snared by Madry. Just picked it up before it hit turf. Mainly a pinch runner in her 1 year at LSU. Flourished with Liberty last year as that's punched into center field for a base hit with two away for Boggs. Eric Backich. One ball and no strikes on the freshman Cabrell. Runner on the move, throw down, not in time. Boggs got underneath it.
Catcher for Liberty really has learned that position this year. Good footwork to get around the batter.
But first pitch swinging, the ground ball goes to Barrett, and she retires Cabral. The softball field was like a rec field, and now it is a premier first-class facility. Cut and a miss, and Rachel Roop is the second strikeout victim of Mikayla Hogue.
Just throw a drop ball. She also throws some off-speed pitches and other pitches, so you can't just sit and hunt on that drop ball.
Hilton just in time to get the speedy Wilson for out number two. And just exactly what we expected. Infield single as the call is overturned. Wilson is on here with one away.
You see her toe on the front of the base before the ball is in the glove. Sometimes you just got to put your foot on the gas and give it your best shot, get a runner in motion.
And that is bobbled by Kuhn. Second error of the game for Virginia.
Just 2:45 coming into this game with runners in scoring position.
And chase the drop ball. There's the bread and butter from Hogue, and it's strikeout number three.
So they are playing the percentages, really shortening the outfield.
And there is Hogue working her way out of trouble. And the defensive miscues don't hurt Liberty whatsoever. We'll talk to the head coach of the Flames, Dot Richardson, when we play one of the most competitive schedules outside of conference. This year, it's the number one non-conference strength of schedule. And one away there as Barrett fires to Fortner, Macy Eaton down.
Two in there. It's not just one thing to play 12 ranked opponents. You've got to find a way to get a couple wins.
Wilson gloves it off of the bat of Kuhn for out number two. They do have some great offense.
Richardson said they're getting better. They're getting more experience under their belt. It was just a little too early to play some of those ranked teams, but they're going to get a chance for redemption later in the season.
Barrett can't make the throw in time, and Weaver beats it out.
Third base in fair territory. That one clearly foul.
Payoff, reached for it, and a pop-up to short. Barrett's got it, and Katie Love is out of this fourth inning. Zeros on the board.
And really the traditional bottom of the ACC, middle of the ACC has gotten better.
There's a leadoff hit for KK Madry, and now the bottom of the order produces here for Liberty. And it has been 14 long years under Joanna Harden, still looking for that first appearance. Throw down to second offline, and a stolen base for Madry.
Well, those are the plays, that pickoff play down to second base. Madry, very, very lucky, very fortunate to be safe. Just got rid of the ball too soon there with Virginia in the rundown.
And there is the first walk of the game.
We're here in this tight game.
1-1 is chopped in front. Hogue to first. Runners move up, though. Very productive out there for Liberty. I'm sure Dot Richardson will take it. Second and third, one away for Liberty. Chopper over to second. The play is to first, and the Flames break through.
And knows what she needs to do. She's going to pull the ball to the right side of the infield, and that allows the speedy Madry to take off. It's a downward angle play. Soon as she reaches
10 games. 0 for 2 today. That'll get away from Boggs. Here comes the runner home. The tag applied. Hydorn trying to steal another one for Liberty, but it ends up being the final out here in the fifth. One coming up for Joanna Harden, Eaton Ayer, and then Jade Hilton. She'll swing through it. Ellie Ayer. And she'll lead off with a dunk into center field. So one on and one out now for Virginia. Tying run is on. Really been stranding those base runners when they do get on. 1-1 sky high. Right side, and it is off of the glove of Fortner. Liberty's not going to get any outs. How do they not at least get Kelly Ayer over at second base? Majority of the inning, she's thrown 40% of their innings so far this year. Swinging at the first pitch once again, and Boggs pops it on the infield. Not what Virginia needed there. Squeeze
to swing early and often.
2-1 bouncer to third. And just barely in time, Crane beats Ayer to the bag. And Virginia is held off the scoreboard once again and through five.
Play sharp defense, aggressive defense. Stay in the game long enough for your offense to win it.
2-2 on the outside corner and taken. First strike three. That's the second time that Rachel Roop is.
And it just doesn't always work out that way.
MC Wilson reaches for that one to Cabrell for out number two. Well, Sunday we've got
ball and certainly in the circle, just the quality depth of their pitching staff.
Back to the circle, and Hogue takes care of Megan Fortner for out number three.
Feistiness, just their ability to dig in when they need to and find themselves in that position here again tonight.
Ground out to second starts off this sixth inning for Virginia, though. Macy Eaton down.
The ball. That's what Georgia Tech is known for in having another strong season offensively.
And that will stay in here for Kuhn. Payoff upcoming here from Love. Right down Main Street. Roger Potts punches out Abby. The Flames number 36 in the RPI. The Cavaliers number 29. They are right on the edge in terms of an at-large berth as that fly ball goes to Weaver in right field. Can't ask for much more, better numbers than that at this point if you're either done.
At the 80 pitch mark, 81 pitches now. It's really
did it hit her in the box or outside? Outside the box, according to home plate umpire Roger Potts. And Reagan Barrett is out. Two away in the seventh.
Wanted as well, but you know, every coach, every player, every pitcher wants just a consistent strike zone, and we've certainly seen that for both teams.
Slow chopper to third. Kuhn makes the throw just in time. And does Virginia have a rally in them? They're gonna need one run to keep this game alive when we come back to Palmer Park. We're gonna get a pinch hitter here, Kalen Jones for Hackett. First pitch swinging again, and the fly ball to Madry's out number one.
Katie Love spinning the ball through the zone and just some fly ball outs from Virginia.
Hot shot from Shelby Barbie from her knees. Barrett throws out Barbie, and Liberty is one out away. We're not even at an hour and 40 minutes at this point. Still alive, though. Virginia gets a single from Ayer, and the tying run is on base. As the error, a pop-up booted by the first baseman, Fortner. 1-0, driven. Right center field, the park will hold it. Wilson makes the catch, and Liberty evens the score. Virginia shut out just once this season coming in. It was March 1st against Boston College.